Annie, you've done a lot of work about sea level rise. Tell me about sea level rise itself and why we monitor it.
First of all, we observe for many decades now that sea level is rising. And this is new because for the last 2,000 years, sea level remains almost constant. And at the beginning of the 19th century, we started gauge oceanographer observed that sea level started to rise. And now we are monitoring this with satellites, and we observe that for the last 20 years, about 20 years, the rate of sea level rise is twice faster than during the previous decades.
So how much is sea level rising by? What's the current rate?
The current rate is a little more than 3 millimeters per year. This seems a very low number, but by the way, since the beginning of the 90s, it corresponds to about 8 centimeters in terms of global mean sea level elevation. And this will continue in the future anyway.
And what's contributing to sea level rise?
First of all, we know that current sea level rise is an indirect consequence of global warming. Global warming caused by greenhouse gases emission and deforestation. And because of global warming, the ocean is warming and land ice is melting. And these are the two main contributors to sea level rise.
And is sea level rise the same all around the world?
Not at all. And we discovered that the rate of sea level rise is not uniform. It depends from one region to another. And we discovered that with satellites, by the way, because before using satellite, we had only information from the tide gauge, instruments that are located along coastlines and on islands, which means that they do not see what is happening in the open ocean. But with satellite, with a global coverage, we discovered that sea level is not rising uniformly. And during the last 20 years, in some regions, the rate of sea level rise has been 3 to 4 times faster than the global mean. And this is in particular the case in the Western Pacific, Western Tropical Pacific, where, as you know, many low-lying islands, atolls, are located. And in this region, people already sea level is rising.
You're talking about sea level rises that are tiny little amounts each year, but you're measuring them from something which is way up in the sky. How can you possibly measure a change in sea level from something that's so far away?
First of all, what we are measuring is along the satellite trajectory is every, let's say, every 5 kilometers, the height of the satellite or the altitude of the satellite with respect to the sea level. And knowing the position of satellite in space, we can deduce the height of the sea level with respect to a constant reference, let's say an ellipsoid that corresponds or coincides with the mean shape of the Earth. So having these measurements of instantaneous sea level all along the orbit, the satellite covering the whole Earth in, let's say, 10 days or 35 days, depending on the kind of orbit, we can average all these measurements during these 10 days or 35 days, which correspond to an orbital cycle, what we call an orbital cycle. That is the time needed for the satellite to globally cover the Earth. We get an estimate of the mean sea level over these 10 days or 35 days interval. And then from one orbital cycle to another, we can construct a curve of the global mean sea level change through time. And now we have a long time series starting in early 1993 with TOPEX Poseidon, and now we have several other satellites. And from one orbital cycle to another, we can construct a curve of the global mean sea level evolution through time. And now we have nearly 25-year long record of the global mean sea level evolution. So this is one thing, this is for the global mean. Now, as I said, the satellite flies over all region of the Earth or the ocean. So at each site in the ocean, we can do the same, that it construct a time series of the local sea level variation and compute, for example, a linear trend. And from that, we can draw a map of special trend patterns over the 25-year period and see that in some regions the trends are larger than in other regions. And this is the way we see that in the tropical western tropical Pacific the rate of sea level rise has been faster or larger than the global mean. It is also the case in the North Atlantic, south of Greenland, and in the Southern Ocean.
So we need satellites to make these measurements because the local sea level rise goes up and down with the tide, and if there's big storms that go past and currents, that changes the height. So you really need this long period of measurement in order to discern these tiny, tiny changes.
Absolutely. The individual sea level measurements are affected by a lot of processes. For example, ocean tides, other processes. So either we remove this phenomena or we average them out in order to only keep the long-term change, let's say interannual variation or even decadal variation. And this is the way we proceed, just by accumulating long records of data and averaging processes that do not interest us.
So the little details aren't so important for you, but those big long-term trends are what matter.
But really, having several satellites in orbit at the same time is really important. And I would like to recall that measuring sea level, global mean sea level evolution is probably the most demanding application of satellite altimetry because of the very tiny signal we are trying to measure.
And yet it works.
And it works.